finite automata are also known as DFA. Now, what is DFA? DFA basically refers to deterministic finite automata, which is nothing but the uniqueness of a computation. The finite automata are called deterministic finite automata if the machine reads an input string one symbol at a time, rather than multiple symbols at a time. In DFA, there is only one path for specific input from the current state to the next state. Now, DFA does not accept null move. That is, DFA cannot change state without any input character. DFA can contain multiple final states. Now, DFA is a collection of five tuples as described in a definition of finite automata. These are as follows, which are Q, which are the finite set of states, sigma, which are the finite set of input symbol, Q0, which is nothing but the initial state, and F, which is nothing but the final state. And finally, we are ending with delta, which is the transition state. And finally, a DFA can also be represented by diagraphs called state diagram, in which, number one, the state is represented by vertices. Number two, the arc labeled with an input character show the transitions. Number three, the initial state is marked with an arrow. And number four, the final state is denoted by a double circle.
Now, the process of reducing a given DFA to its minimal form is called as minimization of DFA. So, the goal of minimization algorithm is to create irreducible automata from arbitrary ones. Now, there can be some bigger automata with some extra functions, like from some extra function that goes from, if we have an input of 1, it goes from 1 to some other state. And if 0, it goes again from some state to other state. And it can be redundant. If it's a redundant automata, then some of the time and some space and some cost of using that will increase. And so to forego that, we make the automata minimized, so that doesn't happen. We can avoid it at any cost. Next slide, please. Now there are several ways of minimization. Now, two ways are basically used, in very widespread ways, are equivalence theorem and Mihl-Nerod theorem. Now, the DFA minimization using equivalence theorem. If X and Y are two states in a DFA, we can combine these two states into X and Y if they are not distinguishable. Two states are distinguishable if there is at least one string S such that one of the delta XS and delta YS is accepting and another is not accepting. Hence, a DFA is minimal if and only if all the states are distinguishable. Now, here are examples of equivalence theorem. Like from the initial diagram, we can see that there are many redundant states. Like if the state in AB and it goes on the second state and the final state from A, from B we have a final state, from A also we can see a final state. Now, there is a very redundant state that going on, like loops and all, it doesn't know what to do and all. So, in a final diagram, we can see that it's a very complete diagram with only one final state and there is no redundant inputs and outputs. So, reducing the automata from its initial state to the initial diagram to the final diagram, we have reduced the cost of states, we've reduced the cost of using more states, using more power, using more resources. So, we have reduced that cost and actually it is very helpful for us in the purpose for which we are using this automata.
So the other process of minimization of DFA is the Mihl-Nerod theorem. It is also called the table filling method. So let's look into the procedure, how to make out this theorem. So first, we have to draw a table for all pairs of states, PQ, not necessarily connected directly. All are unmarked initially. The second step is we have to consider every state pair PQ in the DFA where P belongs to F and Q doesn't belong to F or vice versa and mark them. Here F is the set of final states. And then step 3, we have to repeat this step until we cannot mark any more states. If there is an unmarked state in an unmarked pair PI, QI, mark it if the pair delta of p comma a comma delta of q comma a is marked for some input alphabet. And then the step 4, combine all the unmarked pair p comma u q and make them a single state in the reduced DFA. So this is an example of minimization of DFA using the table filling method.
Thank you again. Very good.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Very good.